People kept telling me not to go out with him. He was like some kind of devil worshiper and stuff. And I met him in Walmart. And he followed me around like a puppy dog. And we started talking. You know, he was real sweet. Not like everybody else was making him out to be. That night, we started going out. And it was like a month. And he called me up on the telephone at my dad's girlfriend's house. He goes, "Will you marry me?" I'm like, "What?" And he goes, "Will you marry me?" I said, "Can you repeat that one more time?" And he goes, "Will you marry me?" I said, "Yeah." When I got pregnant, I had this big picture painted in my mind that, you know, Damien's gonna be there, and I get to yell at him when I have the baby. And instead, I was yelling at her. I miss him so much. And he hasn't got to see the baby. They won't let him touch the baby. It makes me so pissed off.
I just felt different when he was born. It made me feel like, I guess, just real good inside. Just to think that I gave life to another human being. Something completely separate from me, but still part of me. I just hope that I'll be there when he grows up to watch him.
What we want to talk to you about is all the stuff in the paper about a deal with Jesse. Right now we don't know what his situation is, although we think that he is more inclined to testify right now than he has been at any point up to now. The Friday that Jesse was convicted, they questioned him, the officers who took him down inquired of him what had really happened, and apparently Jesse, contrary to somebody that was innocent that would say things like, "Gee, I've just been convicted and I didn't do it, and what a terrible injustice," Jesse talked all the way down there about how he committed the crime and the specific details. Unfortunately, we need his testimony real bad. If it was a perfect world, you know, we would take what we have on Jesse and leave it, and we'd go and get the other two and get them and be happy, but it's not. And we need his testimony to be sure we get convictions on the other two. I think we're gonna negotiate his sentence down some in order to get him to testify.
He's not gonna, you know, testify just out of the goodness of his heart. The only way that I think that he will be willing to testify is if the life sentence is removed. Now, I do want to say all is not lost if he doesn't testify, but the odds are reduced significantly. I mean, we've still got some evidence. What we've got, besides Jesse, is we've got a fiber that was found on, I think it was found on Stevie's shirt, that matched a fiber from Jason Baldwin's mother, which you call secondary transfer. We've got a fiber from a shirt, or a couple of fibers from a shirt found at Eccles' house. One of them was on like the Cub Scout, Michael's Cub Scout cap, another one maybe on the shirt that matched Damien's. Fiber evidence, it's in my opinion, it's better than hair evidence, but they can't say that it came from that particular garment to the exclusion of all others. We've got the Hollingsworth clan that says they saw Damien and Dominique out on the service road. We've got some kids that say that they heard him at a girls' softball game, overheard him say that he killed the three boys and that he was going to kill two more before he turned himself in. And
they haven't scared them off yet like they did the other ones?
Well, no, not yet. We've got a guy that was in jail with Jason, who says that Jason made some incriminating statements to him. Now, there are some things that they are going to try to do to attack this kid's credibility, but, and then we've got the knife that was found in the lake behind Jason's house. So that's what we've got, but that's all. basically, that we've got.
And you asked what the odds were of convicting him without Jesse, and it's, you know, 50-50 might be good.
The only way he'll come up there and sit down in that witness chair and testify is if they cut him a sweet deal. You take all the things that are wrong with his statement and then add to that recipe mix that I'm talking now because I got a sweet deal and I'm going to get out in 10 years, hypothetically. I may get out in 10 years. Well, heck, who wouldn't sing? You know what I'm saying? So then his evidence, his statement, his whole thing looked bad. And if that's their best evidence, and trust me, it is, if they can't use that statement against you, they got nothing. And this dog and pony show is over.
Good morning.
Are the rumors false about Jesse turning state's evidence?
Yes. Good morning.
Is it true that Jesse's going to testify against Damien and Jason?
It's false.
I just left Jesse at the jail, and he told me that he was not going to testify, that he didn't want to get up there and lie. That the officers had been working on him real hard, but he wasn't going to listen to him, and this was his decision was final. But he can always change his mind again. He has, and he's a very confused and scared kid, and the officers have scared him to death.
Yeah, they have. Well, I told him last night, I said, Jesse, if you get up there and lie, I'm going to be in that courtroom. And you're going to have to sit there and tell that lie when you know that I'm sitting there listening to you, when you know I know the truth that you are lying.
Damien, are you worried about Jesse testifying against him?
Most of the time, he came up with the stupid ideas. I guess I influenced him about as much as he influenced me, I guess. Most of the time, we didn't really set out to do anything in particular. We just started hanging around, and whatever happened, just usually happened. Sometimes good, sometimes bad. We were just sitting on the couch watching TV the night we were arrested. The pigs busted in, started running all over the house. We tried to hide in the bedroom when the cops first came, but they wouldn't leave. We were in the bedroom, turned the light off. Maybe they'll go away.
I know, and they're open up.
We saw the lights go out.
And Dominique turned them back on and turned them back
no,
out.
No, it was my sister.
Huh?
The damn system stinks. They're playing with our lives, and there's nothing right about it.
It's kind of like the Nazis, you know, they can just take somebody's word and come in your house and take you away. And basically, that's what they did because of what Jesse told them. Even though it had all those inconsistencies in it.
If we'd had money, you think these three boys would have been picked on? They found people that they knew that didn't have money. Some boys have been in a little bit of trouble. They thought we didn't care. But they're wrong. They're bad wrong.
I don't believe that children could be that cold-blooded as what happened to those boys.
Damien, we're getting close to the end now. How do you feel so far?
I feel good so far. So far, to me, it looks like we've got it beat.
What do you think the worst thing for us right now has been? In the 3 weeks we've been over here, what has hurt the most?
I only know of two things that really hurt. That one kid getting out there for Jason.
Yeah.
And those girls.
You see inside that person, and you look inside there, and there's not a soul in there.
And even if you added all the other things, quote, trappings of occultism, according to Dr. Griffiths, That has nothing to do with this case whatsoever.
Is it a coincidence that this knife is found behind, in the lake, hidden behind Jason Baldwin's house?
Crime scene. It doesn't fit for a kid to bleed to death and not leave a drop behind. For all the other injuries to their faces, these other injuries are gonna bleed too. And there's not a drop of blood? Not a drop of blood?
There have been hundreds of people killed in the name of religion. It is a motivating force. It gives people who want to do evil, want to commit murders, a reason to do what they're doing.
Find somebody who wears black. But they left one thing go by the wayside, is that there's nothing that links Jason to these activities. Not one witness says, that's what he does, that's his beliefs. We don't have a writing, not a drawing, not a picture, not a person, nothing links him to it. But that doesn't matter. That doesn't matter to them. Because he's sitting over there with Damien. They want you to convict him. Guilt by association is a horrible thing.
Did Paul surprise you on his closing?
I think Paul should have left out the guilt by association part.
He came down hard on that, didn't he? Mm-hmm. Do you have any idea he was going to do that?
Mm-hmm. I thought it'd be smart enough to stay away from him.
Hurt your feelings?
I wanted to strangle him.
I first met Jason the morning of his very first appearance at the West Memphis Municipal Court. Why everybody thought it was Jason was because he hung out with Damien. And why did everybody think he was Damien? Because he was the guy who had the weird suit.
My son wore black. They weren't prosecuted because they wore black t-shirts or liked heavy metal music.
I called Jason's house, and Jason and Damien and Jason's little brother were playing video games, and they weren't really talking much, so I remember I got a little irritated at them. And Damien asked me to call him later that night. There was never a night that we never spoke, and I remember that we had talked that night when I spoke to the police. And they came one afternoon and they spoke to me, and I talked to them once, and that was it. On 9/10/1993, I met with Jennifer Bearden at her residence in Bartlett, Tennessee. The interview was a result of having obtained information that she had been on the phone with Damien on the day of the homicide. She informed me of several times when she had been on the phone with Damien and Jason during the afternoon after school and until about 9:30 p.m. on the evening of 5/5/93. I was never given a chance to, you know, at least give them, you know, an alibi to the jury. I mean, I honestly don't think it would have changed their minds. I think they were pretty dead set on what they were going to decide.
Were you watching the jury?
Mm-hmm.
How do you pick it?
With my finger? No. Now I think it was probably about 60-40. 40 for us, 60 against us.
After you get out of here, are you going to buy the beer?
The whiskey. Beer. You want to get a cigar, cut it open, dump all the tobacco out, fill it up with marijuana, smoke the whole thing.
I mean, we got to get you out of here. You got to go to work where you can pay my bill.
I need to get a job at a gas station or something. Change my name to Bob Smith.
Damien, do you think he looks like you?
I don't know. Not really. I think he's got Dominique's ears.
December the 11th, it will be my 35th birthday.
Can you change his diapers, Damien?
Hopefully not.
It will be the 17th birthday that I've spent in this prison.
So do you think you'll be spending more time with your child, Damien?
I have a son who is now almost the same age I was whenever I was locked up.
Come on, Damien, it's time.
We were absolutely poverty-stricken white trash.
So what's his first words gonna be? Not guilty?
His first words would be capital murder.
What's it feel like to go through a month-long trial accused of something you didn't do?
Horrible.
Are you nervous now?
Yeah.
I mean, there's nothing we can do right now but sit around and wait, but you got anything you want to ask me?
Where do we go when the jury comes back out and says I'm not guilty?
Well, where do you want to go? Where do you want to go?
Disneyland, maybe?
Would you? Would you like to go to Disneyland? Have you ever been anywhere out of? Have you ever been on a trip at all?
Heber Springs.
Well, I tell you what, my man, it'd be a joy to take you. Would you like to go? You would, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Do you understand now why we didn't want you to testify?
Yeah.
Can you see how it hurt Damien? I think it did. And he'll see how they talked about his witnesses.
Mm-hmm.
See, they didn't have anything to talk about us. They didn't have anything to talk about because we didn't give them a chance. And, man. It's heavy. Do you think that this will change at all how you choose your friends?
Yeah.
What do you think this would do? What do you think this is going to do to you and Damien, you and your friendship with Damien?
Stop it, I guess. Yes.
Would you stop being his friend?
I wouldn't be his enemy, but after this, he probably wouldn't be around or that.
You heard what was said about him. Do you think you could have done it?
About what they said?
Yeah, do you think he could have? Do you think Damien could have killed those little boys?
They made it seem like he did.
What do you think?
I don't know.
If you were on that jury, would you have a hard time letting him go? Based on what you heard?
Yeah.
I would too.
Would you let yourself go?
Yeah. If I was up there, I'd let myself go today.
The answer I wanted to hear.
As you know, you didn't do it, don't you?
Yeah.
I went to see Damien yesterday, and for the first time in 4 years, I got to touch him. I got to hug him, and it was hard to believe how much he had grown taller. He was at least a head taller than I was.
I can't believe he had to go all that time without even being able to give him a hug.
He's 20-something years old, but he's still my baby. And that's what it felt like when I put my arms around him. And then he sat down. You could tell he was really nervous because he's been out by himself for so long. He was having a really hard time being around people.
I was allowed to visit with Jason after he was sentenced.
And it was the first contact visit we had had in a year. It was thrilling to be able to hug him, but then I had to let him go and go to this horrible place for something he didn't do. When I start thinking about what all they go through in prison, my mind, I just can't handle it, you know. I just start freaking out when I try to start imagining what Jason's life must be like or Damien's life must be like.
I heard a lot of stuff that had happened to Damien that it's really, really hard to deal with. You're in a position where you can't do anything. And if you stop and think about it very much, some of the things that are done to him, I think it could make you lose your mind knowing that something like that's being done to your child.
Because what's happened to them in prison is gonna affect them for the rest of their lives.
When they come home, it'll never be like it ever was, because these boys were just children too. Whenever these little boys were murdered, our boys were just children too.
I never knew what hell could be like until these last 4 years. My whole life has changed. Lost my home, my job. Nothing seems to matter anymore. It's kind of like that song. I got a song I dedicated to Jason. It's Nothing Else Matters by Metallica. That's my song to him, because really, I feel like most of the time nothing else matters to me but getting Jason home. And I just don't know how I do it.
Damien, when our visiting time's over, he always stands up and puts his hand against the glass for me to put mine against his. We're not actually touching, but we are. It's in the heart anyway.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the bailiffs inform me that you've arrived at verdicts. If you have, pass them to the bailiff, please, or the sheriff. Verdict reads as follows. We, the jury, find Damien Echols guilty of capital murder in the death of Stevie Branch. We, the jury, find Damien Echols guilty of capital murder in the death of Chris Byers. We, the jury, find Damien Echols guilty of capital murder in the death of Michael Moore. We, the jury, find Jason Baldwin guilty of capital murder in the death of Chris Byers. We, the jury, find Jason Baldwin guilty of capital murder in the death of Stevie Branch. We, the jury, find Jason Baldwin guilty of capital murder in the death of Michael Moore. All of the verdicts are signed by the foreman. Ladies and gentlemen, it's necessary at this time that the court poll the jury as to all six verdicts. So when your name is called, if these six verdicts represent your individual verdict, then answer yes as your name is called. Juror number one.
Yes.
Juror number 2. Yes. Juror number 3. Yes. The prosecution didn't have any evidence, but they don't care. Just because somebody wears black and has different beliefs, they're going to convict them of something.
Poor parents. Yeah, I'm sorry for them, but...
I'm sorry for the kids.
I don't give a damn about the parents, but I'm sorry for the kids.
I'm not sorry for anybody.
There's no reason to kill 3 more boys. They didn't do a damn thing. Right now, I wish I was a witch. Talk about a spell on somebody. Boy, I'd put a good one on.
I guess Gitchell goes out with a big bang, because you know he's fucking gonna retire.
Is that
retire too. He's going to retire now. He's probably going to run for office. I got an office for him. Mayor of hell.
As far as I'm concerned, West Memphis can go to hell.
West Memphis is hell.
Sheriff, sure, it's locked, yeah. Showing right behind you.
The black one or blue? 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 Blue?
Yes. Yeah.
Put my 20 years in, and hopefully this is the last case I'll have of this magnitude. Hopefully it's my last case, and I'm leaving on a high note, so there's no better way to leave than your head up high and proud.
I'm not surprised if that's what you're asking. You know, I told you earlier I thought the evidence was more than sufficient to make those findings.